How about verse 7?
The book of Jonah, chapter 2, verses 1 and verses 10.
Okay, but it's just meaning you got to know what's on 11 and 10, sorry.
Verses 11.
No.
I mean 10.
Jonas 1, Jonas 2, chapitre 2, portant verset 1, et dans verset 10.
We're reading from the book of Jonah, chapter 2, verses 1 and verse 10.
So keep those reading to take my son from my eyes.
And when we've got it, we will stand up in Jesus' name. I read in Jesus' name. Then Jonah prayed to the Lord, his God, from inside the fish. Then the Lord ordered the fish to spit up Jonah on the beach, and it did. Amen.
Amen. Le Seigneur envoya un grand poisson qui avala Jonas. Durant 3 jours et 3 nuits, Jonas demeura dans le ventre du poisson. Nakenaten, sur un ordre du Seigneur, le poisson rejeta Jonas sur la terre ferme. Amen.
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 Béni soit le Seigneur qui parle. Tovani na bisona pour mon Jésus. Alléluia.
Amen.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Je tiens jusqu'à la mort. Je tiens jusqu'à la mort. Je tiens jusqu'à la mort. Je serai chrétien. Jusqu'à la mort, chrétien,
jusqu'à la mort,
oh, chrétien,
jusqu'à la mort,
chrétien, jusqu'à la mort, je serai chrétien jusqu'à la mort, fidèle.
The Lord has sent a fish, a large fish, that swallowed Jonah for 3 days and 3 nights.
Jonas aumeli kati na libumu na mbisi.
Jonah remained in the stomach of the fish. And in verse 10 it says,
na motindo ya nkolo,
from the order of God,
misi akeyi kobwaka Jonas na mabele,
The fish went to spit Jonah onto the ground.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Tozomona awa nzambe atindi mbisi.
We see here that the Lord had sent a fish to swallow Jonah. But Jonah was a servant of God. Jonah was a servant of God. Jonah believed in God. God knew him. And he also knew God. And he feared God. But then God sent him to go to preach the word in the land of Nineveh. Because Nineveh was lost. Nineveh was not destroyed. And sin was sitting on Nineveh. The children of Nineveh were lost in the sin that
happened.
And the sin of Nineveh came onto the presence of
God.
The smell of the sin of Nineveh came into the presence of God. And God saw that it was time to destroy Nineveh.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because anywhere in any land, if the sin goes into the presence of God, that land has to be destroyed. Because the sin of these people will sit onto the
land,
and it will sit onto the sea, and it will also sit on the tree.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When sin gets too much, physically, when somebody has too much sin, you will see that the physiology will change.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The people that sin, you will find that they have changed. People that have seen that know that you will see that the eyes are somehow, the face is somehow.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The same way that sin will change somebody's
it will change body,
it will also change your body. The same way that sin, if in the land is too much, it will change the entire country and the entire
people.
Because sin brings out smell. That's why you cannot hide it.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Sin brings out a smell. And when it's grown, you cannot hide it anymore. You can hide it for one day, but it will not remain for 2 days. You can hide it for 2 weeks, 1 week, but it will not remain for 2 months. You can hide it for a month, but it will not be for years and years.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And in the land, if there's no people, if sin is sitting on them, the sin will affect the sea of that population. The sin will affect the land of that place. And the sin will also affect the trees that surround that land. And that's why you find that there is so much sin, there is hardship in the land.
They
will be crying in the land. People are working, but they're not receiving.
Amen.
Amen. The ground
starts to dry,
and the rain starts to not come.
Amen.
Amen.
Bakonzi bakomi korompi.
The leaders become corrupt. They are not concerned about the people anymore. And everybody is only looking for themselves. The people become become selfish. And they become friends of money. And money starts to lead their lives. Because of money, people are capable of selling their children.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And this is the situation that
was Nineveh.
And God saw that it was time to destroy Nineveh. But the sorrow of God was in his heart. God said, the people that I had created, I will not destroy them just anyhow. Because they do not understand me, let me send a person to
Jonas.
And God sent Jonah. Jonah was given the mission to go to Nineveh. But because it was the people that did not get along with Jonah, the servant of God, was happy for God to destroy those people.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want you to understand. God could have destroyed Nineveh because they was too much. But God understood that Nineveh was in ignorance. They have not understood their sin. It needs to show them their sin. Then God will then be able to destroy.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So nobody in Nineveh can give the reason and say that God, we did not know.
That's what's gonna happen at Suka Town.
This is what's gonna happen at the end of time. Nobody on this earth can say that I did not hear the name
of Jesus.
And that's why the Bible says the sign of the coming of Jesus is when the word of God is spread all over the world.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 But Jonas did not want to go and preach there. Because Jonah was happy for God to destroy the people of Israel. But God had love for these people. Even though they did not want him, but God loved them anyway. That's why he wanted to give them the last alert. To warn them the last time. So he sent Jonah. I will not go deep into all of this. I'm jumping. Jonah ran away. He did not want to go there. You all know the story. He took the boat and he went to a different land. But in the land that he wanted to run away to, and God said to him, nobody on this earth can run away from him. Nobody on this earth can run away from
him.
Nobody on this earth can manipulate God. You can lie to your
doctor.
You can lie to your doctor. You can lie to your wife or your husband. You can even lie to yourself. You can lie to your pastor. But your conscience, you will not lie to. And your God, you will not lie to.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Jonah wanted to run away from God. Jonah wanted to run away from God. But on this earth, there is no way that you can run away from God. There is no place that you can hide from God. Psalm says, God is observing us. His eyes pierces through.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That was San Zambe pensa pa.
When they say the eyes of God pierce through. When we look through the window, we see what is behind the window.
And
when you go through.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 God, when he looks at you, he looks at you through the window. He sees the entire being. That's why the Bible says he's the God that sees our hearts.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Nothing that you can do, you can hide from God. And Jonah wanted to do this. He wanted to run away. So the people of Nineveh did not be saved. So God can destroy them. But Jonah did not know the heart of God. But Jonah did not know the love that God has with his children. That's why the Bible tells us that God has no preference.
When we were lost, God knows whom we will choose and whom he will reject. Hallelujah.
Amen. God himself knows who he will choose and who he will reject.
Amen.
Amen. Jonah wanted God to reject Nineveh. But God knew that he is the God of the last chance. And you need to give them the last opportunity. And that's why he sent Jonah. And Jonah had run away. He took the boat and he went somewhere else. But the Bible is telling us, God has sent a big fish. And that fish swallowed Jonah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That fish swallowed Jonah.
But I mean that the Bible says
it doesn't say that the enemy has sent the fish. The Bible says that God has sent the fish.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When God wants you, even if you run away, he will get you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When God wants you to do something, even if you refuse, he has ways to force you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Especially if you are chosen by God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You can refuse, but at the end you will give up.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And Jonah was in this position. They asked him to go to Manchester. He went to Dover to get the ship to go to France.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God sent the fish. And that fish that swallowed Jonah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Jonah on the road to go to France. The fish swallowed him.
Amen.
Amen. God sent Jonah to go to Finland. God sent Jonah to go to Brazil. Go to Canada. Go to even Russia and Mongolia.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jonah
got onto the boat. And he was going to South Africa. God sent the fish. The Bible says a big fish.
This one is malicious.
And that fish swallowed Jonah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Russia.
Jonah should have gone to
Russia,
but he's going to South Africa. And the fish swallowed him.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
When they threw him into the sea, the fish swallowed him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And in the belly of the fish, the fish remains, a fish does not live on land, it lives in the sea.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As a aquatic.
The fish is aquatic. They live in the sea, they are able to breathe in the sea.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But a man lives in the sea because our body is not adapted to live in the sea.
Amen.
Jonas, they took him, they threw him into the sea.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And in that sea, the fish came and took him. The fish swallowed him on his way to South Africa. But that fish took him, turned around, and went all the way back to Russia where they had sent him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Me and you sometimes we are in the same situation. God had told you to go this way, but you said, no, I do not want to go this way. God, in the school they didn't teach me this way, in the school they taught me that way. You want to do as you please. You want to do things as it will give advantage to you. But God says not that way.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We are always people that want to give arguments to God. We want to defend ourselves in front of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 And Jonah was sent to Russia and he was on his way to
South Africa.
He wanted God to destroy Nineveh. And God had sent the fish. And the fish swallowed him up. The Bible says it was a massive, it was a big fish.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The fish lived inside the sea. Because the fish has the ability to breathe. But us people, God did not create us to live in the sea. If you will live in the sea, you will remain there for maybe 1 hour, 2 hours, 10 hours.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But swim about professional, I go stay in the water, but 10 hours, 12 hours.
Professional swimmers, they can stay in the water for 10 hours, 12 hours. But us civilians, if we fall into the sea, some of us will last only a minute.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Those who know how to swim, they may remain a little
bit.
Jonas in the sea, in the belly of the fish. And that fish is in the sea.
But me mean about big fish.
Because many big fishes, they live really deep in the sea. I want you to understand. The large fishes, they live deep in the sea.
Amen.
Amen.
Some of them.
Some of them will come at the top to breathe and then they go back down. Some of them, they will come at the top to get some sunlight and then go back down.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The fish in the sea. And Jonah in the belly of the fish. How will he breathe?
Amen.
Amen. Let's say that he will breathe the air of the fish.
Amen.
Amen.
There's no time here. I'm going to explain that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I will pay my point with the ambition.
He will breathe the air of the fish.
Is that what you are doing in a chambre?
Is that you put yourself in a room?
But you can chauffage.
You put yourself in a room and you turn on the heating. You will breathe properly because you have some space. But if the air of the heater fills up the room, then you are able to die. Because the air, if it's not escaping, what's remaining there will just turn around. You know that we breathe in air. We breathe in oxygen. But once it's inside of us, it becomes dirty and we breathe out. For us to be well, we exchange with trees.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You
breathe in good air and you
breathe out the dirt.
And when you release it and it's dirty,
and the trees take it
and they change it and they send it out again.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Jonah inside the belly of the fish, if he depends on only the air of the fish, he will also suffocate.
Amen.
Amen. But the Bible says, it says that God ordered the fish to go spit him out onto the ground.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That fish and went to go spit him where he had run away from. The fish did not know his
program.
The fish did not know his
program.
The fish was not there when God had but God is capable of communicating to anything that he has created. And
he gave
the order to go and spit him out where he needed him to go. And Jonah, when he came out, and he looked around, and he said, I've ended up in South Africa. And they asked people, where are we? And they said, here we are in Russia.
No, near Panimai Paruski. Gavaris Paruski. Yeah, Claude, Baraba Bond. Claude Atema. Hallelujah.
Amen. He thought he came out in South Africa, but then he heard Russian.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And he understood this is the place that I was coming from. And when the fish had brought him back to that place, then he understood the revelation. And he understood that it's the word of God. So I have to preach the word to Nineveh.
Amen.
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 Amen. But during this time, the fish had swallowed him. He knew that he was dying. He knew that he would die. And when the fish had swallowed him, and you see in verse 2 that he started to pray
God.
He ran away from the work of God, but when he was in trouble, he started to pray to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But actually, when you read this scripture properly, and you follow the prayer of Jonah in the belly of the fish, and you find in verse 7, you understood that he had died.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When you get to 7, you realize that Jonah had died.
Now, which are we getting down?
That's when he remembers God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And you and me were the same way. When hardship comes on us, we think of God. We remind ourselves of God. And that's why we're
prophesying.
We will only come and cry unto God. A person can give you a solution, but a person is
limited.
Only God can give you a solution. Only God can give you a
solution.
Only God can give you a strong solution. Only God can give you the eternal solution. That's why when you have a problem, no matter how hard it is, open your heart to God. Speak to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I've already told you that nobody can run away from God. Nobody can lie to God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You can lie to your doctor, but it will not help you. If somebody is sick in the head, if you have a headache and you go to the GP and you tell them that you have a bellyache,
what's going to happen?
If you go to a doctor and you've got a
headache
and you tell the doctor that your belly is hurting, he will give you a medicine. Because you came with the problem,
but of
the
family,
you also need the medicine for
and
that medicine, if you take it, will it take away your headache?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
But the real problem is not your stomach but your head, but you've gone to God and lie.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 That's why Jonah said and then he understood that he was let me put myself back in the right path.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And he opened his heart in truth. And when he opened his heart in truth, God gave him back that breath. This is still inside the belly of the fish. And that's why God ordered the fish to go and
pick him out.
Because he opened his heart to God. And when I look at it deeply, even though the Bible does not say it, then I think that he asked God to forgive him for the disobedience that he had done. Because he refused to go where they had sent him. That is a rebellion. It's a revolt. It's breaking the laws of God. And for you to go back with God, you need to first fix that situation.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Whatever is stopping you from getting into the presence of God, if you do not fix it, even if you give your offerings, nothing will change. Even if the servant of God pray over you, even if you fast for days and days, first you have to change the situation where you rebel. And the Bible says God, he ordered the fish to swallow Jonas.
Hallelujah.
Amen.